When we first open the Bible, we will see the first chapter of Genesis, and it foretold the creation of the world and us, humanity. In this film, I will start with Noah, who built a boat, also known to many as Noah's Ark. He was instructed by God to prepare for the great flood that will kill many. When you read a story in the Bible, sometimes it's hard to understand the deep meaning of the words. And now, by the power of technology, I can show you visually how it feels and completely understand it. This is the Genesis. Enjoy.
In the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth. And God said, "Let there be light." And there was light. Then God separated the water and the sky. He formed the seas and the land. Then he covered the land with trees and plants. Then he filled the world with all the creatures of the sea. Of the air, and all the creatures of the ground. And then he made us. To live in paradise. Until Adam and Eve disobeyed God and ate the forbidden fruit. And with one choice, they learned both good and evil. Since then, since Cain killed Abel, God has seen too much evil in human hearts. Wrong choices, wrong decisions. That's why this is happening. Our Creator decided to cleanse the earth. God warned me. He told me to build a boat. A boat to save our family and all the animals. Every other living creature would die. And on the seventh day, God rested. Thank you.
After the floodwaters engulfed the world, the Bible describes a new beginning for Noah's descendants and a chance to restore the relationship between God and humanity. A new faith in an all-powerful Creator is being born.
I always wonder what is the right way to pray. Would I pray to complain? Would I pray to ask for help? Would I pray to give thanks? In the Bible, on Luke 18, verse 9 to 14, our Lord Jesus tells a story about a Pharisee and a tax collector. The Pharisee prayed and praises himself, while the tax collector prayed and asked God for mercy. This is the part where Jesus met the apostle Matthew, who is a tax collector in this time period, and becomes Jesus' follower. In my understanding, when you pray, be humble, and you will receive God's blessing. In this film, I will show you visually how it feels for you to see and understand it. This is Jesus, the Pharisee, and the tax collector. Enjoy.
All taxes must be paid in full!
Take it away!
No!
Go!
They're all Jews. How can they live with themselves? Our own people working for Rome. These people make me sick.
Collaborators, let's move on.
The stinking vermin. You should keep your distance from
them. Two men went to the temple to pray. One a Pharisee, and the other one a tax collector. The Pharisee prayed, "God, I thank you that I'm not like other men, thieves, adulterers, or this tax collector. But the tax collector didn't even look up to heaven. He said, God, have mercy on me. I'm a sinner. God bless the tax collector, not the Pharisee. Anyone who praises himself for be humbled, and anyone who humbles himself will be praised.
Matthew, come.
Now he even calls the sinners to follow him. One has to wonder of the sins committed by his other followers.
The prayers during the Pentecost. For me, this is a very powerful scene, and it shows the power of prayers. The apostles were celebrating this festival when the Holy Spirit descended on them. It sounded like a very strong wind, and it looked like tongues of fire. The apostles then found themselves speaking in foreign language, inspired by the Holy Spirit. Now, to tell it in a story is not so fascinating, but if I can show you that visually, you will feel the power and understand it. Here is the apostle during the Pentecost as the Holy Spirit descended on them. Feel the power and joy.
It's 50 days since Passover, the day Jesus was crucified. Now thousands of Jewish pilgrims come to Jerusalem for the festival of Pentecost.
John, I'm glad you're all safe. It's good to see you again, Stephen. Matthew.
What form will it take? When will it come? Jesus said all we had to do is ask. I have been asking. Every day.
The Holy Spirit will come when the time is right. I think we should pray together. Our Father, who is in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Languages.
The Holy Spirit. He is with us.
Jesus, your name is power, breath and living water, such a marvelous mystery. Jesus, Jesus. tribes and peoples and languages standing before the throne and before the Lamb, clothed in white robes with palm branches in their hands, and crying out with a loud voice, "Salvation belongs to our God who sits on the throne and to the Lamb."